We can't see it, but it is pretty easy to prove with a magnetic bar and a couple of nails. What about wind? We can't see it, but it's very difficult to deny when you go to Central Park and see the trees moving back and forth from day to day. You even search for the next breeze after PEW. Thanks to Isaac Newton, we learn about gravity, the force that pulls things down, of which we cannot see but is there. I wonder if anyone here has physically seen God. I haven't. I don't think there's anyone who can see God because he is the spirit and we can't see him. Is God kind of something or someone that we can't see but is fully and really there? If he is the one that we cannot see, then how do we know he's really there? Well, the Bible tells us there's a cloud of witnesses who met him, encountered him, felt him, and eventually knew him personally. In this new chapel, we will meet those ancestors of faith one by one from the book of Hebrews, chapter 11. My passage today is Hebrews 11, verses 1 to 2. Now, faith is confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see. This is what the ancients recommended. Before we dive into this passage, let me give you some brief background on the book of Hebrews. Hebrews has two primary purposes: to encourage Jewish Christians to endure and to warn them not to abandon their faith in Christ. The author of Hebrews is unknown, but it is believed to be written sometime between maybe 68 and 95. Though it does not have a typical form of letter, Hebrews is commonly referred to as a letter. After Jesus rose from the dead and visited his disciples, they were all overjoyed. Unfortunately, one of the disciples named Thomas somehow missed the occasion to see the risen Christ himself. He said to the other disciples, "Unless I see the nail marks in his hands and put my finger where the nails were and put my hand into his side, I will not believe it." Without tangible proof, he won't believe anything. Do you remember what Jesus said to him? "Blessed are those who have not seen and believed." Why does the Bible keep telling us to believe to trust and have faith? Why can't God just show up and prove to us that he is there? The world is made up of visible and invisible things. If you believe only in the visible things because you can see them, what would you do with all the invisible things? Are you just going to ignore them all just because you can't see them? What if those invisible things are really important for your life? Without weight, how can you fly kite? When you only believe in the visible, you lose the whole invisible of the world, where really important things for our life are there. One obvious example is God. If you do not believe in God because you cannot see God, is there anything you can hope for from only something visible in this world? Another example is friendship. If you only admire your friend because of the presents and gifts they give you, would you ignore their heart or origin and care for you? When it comes to your faith, you believe in what you do not see. But faith is much more than observation of things, believing in something that is more visible. Faith, according to our passage, has to do with that code. Faith is trust to choose one. Mark chapter 5, verses 25 to 34, tells a story about a sick woman. She has been subject to bleeding for 12 years, gone to doctors, but gotten worse. As her burden to carry got bigger and bigger, her hope for life got dimmer and dimmer. She was ignored by all the community because of her sickness. All the people she knew as well as her old friends did not want to meet her. She was excommunicated from the services of the synagogue, divorced, and thus shut down from the temple. The personal, social, economic, and religious life was entirely collapsed. As the light of her hope was almost snapped out, she happened to see Jesus passing by, surrounded by a crowd of people. Everybody saw Jesus with their eyes, but not everyone had faith to trust his power to heal. She was courageous to touch Jesus' cloak, and her bleeding stopped. When the woman touched his garment, she was not just physically healed, but made whole. Jesus responds, "Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace and be free from your suffering." Her faith is much more than the intellectual assent that she acknowledges what she can see. Her faith is confident in what she hopes for. This is why Jesus commended and encouraged her. I am sure her faith got even stronger when she learned Jesus who healed her, died, rose again for her eternal hope. Last school year during May, I was going through a really stressful and difficult time because my schedule was absolutely packed. I had 2 orchestra concerts, a dance production, a viola performance, and 2 solo concerts. On top of that, we had CD before testing, ceremony and mount excavation, preparation for spring concert, and my mom's close friend's passing. My 2 only emotions during that whole month were anger and frustration. I clearly was thinking God didn't care, God was innocent, and my faith about about him was very cheap. However, I remember Miss Payne prayed for me one afternoon, and I was bawling my eyes out, praying that whatever amount of burden was put on my back, I would always believe that God would carry it with me, and I would trust that He was always there listening to my cries. This is not like trying harder to believe, nor self-hypnotism, nor self-confidence. It is the power of God that gives me faith, God's power to do what He had promised. Whenever my faith becomes shaky, I go back to His promise again and again. He clearly revealed the truth. Scripture, where it says, "He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things?" This is my faith, my confidence, and my hope. You all might be going through very difficult times, and your faith might be shaky, but always believe in God's presence, though you cannot see him. Because look forward to the next challenge speeches where you will learn to listen to God's people, who are going through hard times, never lost their faith in Christ, because they have the promise never shaken through Christ, who died and rose again for eternal hope. God bless you all.